hope you all are healthy and fit at your place. So today we are here with a new video or a new topic of Introduction to Microsoft Word 2010. Here in this video we will learn about the word processor and the difference between the word processor and the text editor. So, or we will also learn about the basic definition of MS Word, features and the components of MS Word's window. For further detailed knowledge about the topic, we will move to our slideshow screen. Here in this video, we will learn about the Microsoft Word 2010. So first, we will discuss that what is a word processor. A word processor is an application software. Application software, we have already discussed, the software that are designed to solve the user's specific problem are called the application software. So, a word processor or a word processing program does exactly what the name implies. It processes the words. Words means the characters or the symbols. It also processes the paragraph, pages and entire papers. Some examples of word processing programs include Microsoft Word, WordPerfect for Windows only, AppleWorks for Mac OS and the OpenOffice.org. So basically, a word processor is an application software which is capable of creating, editing, saving and printing a document. A word processor should never be confused with a text editor such as Notepad. The notepad or the text editors allows us to only create and edit the plain text, whereas the word processor allows us to make changes and illustrate with the text. Basically, the answer is writing that here in this type of word processing software, we can perform number of operations like we can edit our text, we can format our text, we can add the pictures, we can perform number of operations on our text. That's why we call it the word processor. So, some of the popular word processors are Microsoft Word, OpenOffice.org, Google Docs, Notepad and WordPad, LibreOffice Writer, etc. But right now we are using the MS Word. It's a desktop utility. So, the next topic is what is a Microsoft Word 2010? Microsoft Word 2010 is also called the MS Word 2010. It is used to make professional quality documents, letters, reports, etc. MS Word is a word processor developed by the Microsoft Corporation. It has an advanced feature which allows us to format and edit our files and documents in the best and possible way. Basically, now we will learn that what are the uses of our Microsoft Word. The Microsoft Word enables the user to do write-ups, create documents, resume writing, contracts, etc. This is one of the most commonly used programs under the Office suite. The next is, what are the features of a word processor? Unlike the basic plain text editor, a word processor offers several additional features that can give a document or other text a more professional appearance, means a look. Below, it is the listing of some of the most word popular features are the text formatting. Here, we will use the MS Word word processor. So, we will learn the basic features of that word processor. The first feature is the text formatting. Text formatting means we can change the font, font size, font color, bold, italic and underline, etc. These all the things comes under the text formatting option. The next is copying, cutting and pasting. Once text is entered into a document, it can be copied or cut and pasted in the current document or the another document. The next is multimedia. We can insert clip arts, charts, images, pictures and video into a document. The next is spelling and grammar. MS Word provides us a feature to check our writing, our write-up spelling and grammar. It checks for spelling and grammar errors in a document. The next thing is the adjusting the layout. It is capable of modifying the margin size and layout of a document. Basically, the margin means the gap. Feature is the find feature.
The word processors give you the ability to quickly find any word or the text in any size of a document. The next feature is search and replace option. We can use the search and replace feature to replace any text throughout a document. Means we can search any text from the document and we can easily replace that. Control plus H is the shortcut key to replace any word. The next is indentation and list. It sets and formats tabs, bullet list and number list. Means it provides us a feature through which we can create the list in our document. It can be an alphabetic series, a numeric list, the bullet one at all. It can depend upon the user's choice. The next thing is insert the table. Adding the tables is the another feature of MS Word. We can create the tables and according to our requirement, like we can add the number of rows and number of columns according to our need. The next feature is the word wrap feature. Word processor can detect the edges of a page or a container and automatically wrap up the text using the word wrap option. The next feature is we can insert the header and footer. Being able to adjust and change the text in the header and footer of a document. The next thing is thesaurus. It is look up an alternative to word without leaving the program. It is just like the dictionary. The next thing is the multiple windows. While working on a document, you can have additional windows with other document for comparison or move text between the documents. Suppose I have right now I'm working with the PowerPoint presentation. So along with that presentation, I can also open the MS Word window. The next feature is the autocorrect feature. The autocorrect feature automatically corrects the common error. Example, typing TEH and having it autocorrected to the. It will also show up the option like tack ET. The next is mailers and labels. Create mailers or print labels. The next is importing the data or import the data. It allows us or it has a feature to import and format the data from CSV or from the database or from the another source. Now, here we will learn about the components of MS Word window. So here the window that you have seen on your screen is called the components. Or the MS Word window. So here first we will learn about the components, then we will explain it in brief. So here at the top right leftmost corner you will find the menu called the file menu. So here this bar file menu, this is called the file tab. The topmost bar where the document area, document 1 is written, it is called the title bar. Basically, it displays the title of our document window. The next is quick access bar. At the top leftmost corner, the bar, this bar that you can see, it is called the quick access toolbar. From the file tab to this area, this is called the ribbon. Here the number series that is written here, it is called the ruler, and this question mark is the help. Here you have seen three windows on your screen, minimize, maximize and the close button. These are the window controller that controls your whole soul window. Means if you want to minimize it, then you can press this one. If you want to restore and maximize the window, then you can press this button. And if you want to close your document, then you have to press this cross button. This one is the menu bar where home, insert, page layout, reprints, mailing, review, view, add-ins, these options are written here. Clipboard, font, paragraph, these are the groups and the tools that are that you have seen just below the menu bar. This bar is called the toolbar. Basically, the ribbon is made up of menu bar, toolbar and the groups. The next thing is the dialog box launcher. Here, a small arrow that you have seen in that font group area, this is called the dialog box launcher. It is used to launch any particular dialog box. Here, these are the zoom controllers that allows you to zoom in or zoom out your particular document. These are the view buttons, and here, this is called the document area where you can write your text. This bar is called the status bar. It shows you the status of your page or your document, like page 1 of 1, in which page you are working, how many words you have right here, which language you are using. So it shows us the status of our document. Now, we will learn in brief about the components of MS Word window. The first component is File tab. The File tab replaces the Office button from the Word 2007. Means in Office 2007, we have Office button. But now in 2010, it is replaced with the File tab option. You can click it to check the backstage views. This is where you come when you need to open or save the files. Means here you can get the option to open and save the files. Here you can also get the option like create new documents, print a document, and do other file related operations by clicking on this File tab option. The next component is Quick Access Toolbar. This you will find just above the File tab. Here you have seen like just above the File tab. This is the Quick Access Toolbar. Quick Access Toolbar, and this is a convenient resting place for most frequently used commands in Word. You can customize this toolbar based on your comfort. Means we can add here. By default, it is having three options like save, undo, and redo. You can customize it according to your choice. If you want to quickly access any tool, then you can just add that tool in the quick access bar. Just click on this small menu and just right click on it and go to the customize option where you can get number of tools to add on. The next is ribbon. A ribbon contains command organized in three components. The one tabs. Tabs means the venue, groups, and the commands. Basically tabs. These appears across the top of the ribbon and contains the groups of related commands like the menus, home menu, insert menu, page layout menu are the example of the ribbon tabs. The next thing is group. Basically they are organized related commands. Each group name appears below the group on the ribbon. For example, group of commands related to the font of a group that I have already shown you related to the alignment etc. The next thing is commands. Commands appear within each group as the mentioned above, like the tool. The next thing is the title bar. Title bar basically it is found at the top of the window. This lies in the middle and at the top of the window. Title bar shows the program and the document title. The next thing is ruler. MS Word has two rulers, a horizontal ruler and a vertical ruler. The horizontal ruler appears just beneath the ribbon and it is used to set the margins and tab stops, the horizontal one. Whereas the vertical ruler appears on the left edge of the Word window and it is used to cog the vertical position of the elements on the page. The next menu is Help. The Help icon can use to get Word related help anytime you like. This provides nice tutorials on various subjects related to the Word. It may or may not be used the online version. The next feature is the Zoom control option. The Zoom control lets you zoom in for a closer look at your text. The Zoom control consists of a slider that you can slide left or the right to zoom in or zoom out. You can click plus button to increase or decrease the zoom factor. The next is view buttons. The view buttons is having number of views, like first the print layout view. It is the by default view in which we are working in the MS Word, the print layout view. This displays pages exactly they will appear when printed. The next is full screen reading view. This gives the full screen view of the document. The next thing is web layout view. This shows how a document appears when viewed by a web browser such as Internet Explorer. The next thing is the outline view. We have 5 views in MS Word. The next is outline view. This lets you work with outlines established using Word standard heading style. The next is draft view. This format text as appears on the printed page with a few exceptions. For example, header and footers aren't shown in the draft view. Most people prefer this mode. So we have five views while we are working with the MS Word. The by default view is print view, in which we work by default. Print, full screen, web layout, outline, and the draft view. The next thing is document area. Document area means this is the area where you can type. The flashing vertical bar is called the insertion point, and it represents the location where text will appear when you type. The next thing is status bar that I have shown you. This displays the document information as well as the insertion point of location. From left to right, this bar contains the total number of pages, the words in the document, the language, etc. The next is dialog box launcher. The dialog box launcher appears as very small arrow in the lower right. I have shown you in the font dialog box option, corner of many groups on the ribbon. It is found on the corner of many groups of the ribbon. Just clicking this button open a dialog box or task pane that provides the more options about the group. So that's all about the components of MS Word window. Now we can also create any new document, we can open any existing one, we can save any document, we can rename any document, we can save as any document, we can print, we can set the password, we can add on the number of things, like we can add the photo in a document, and number of things we will do in this MS Word window. So basically the MS button of 2007. Here, the key point or the main difference between the MS Word 2007 and 2010 is that the office button is replaced by the file tab in Word 2010, and we can customize the quick access bar according to our need. So once I'll show you again the window of components of MS Word. Here at the leftmost corner, the file tab instead of the office button. At the top, the quick access bar. The quick access bar allow you to quickly access the commands from the words window. The next thing is the title bar. Title bar, basically it shows you the title of your page, or it displays the current document name. Right now we haven't given any name to the document. Once we save this document, that name shown here. The next is the ribbon. From this area to this area, this is called the ribbon. Now the next thing is the ruler bar. So basically these are the rulers, the ruler bar, and these are also the ruler. Here these are the view tabs. By default we are having the five views that we have discussed. By default we are working with the print view. Print view, outline view, design view, draft view, and layout view. Okay, these are the zoom controls, zoom in and zoom out buttons. So I hope you all are getting all the things whatever I have explained here.
That's all about today's information. If you have any doubt, any query related to the video, then you can ask me, you can drop a message in my Dropbox, or you can WhatsApp me. And one more thing, that you have to complete your work on time and forward it to me. Thank you. Have a nice day.